Ola Naitoko is a senior customs officer charged in a major seizure of drugs and guns, including more than 6 kilos of meth. His arrest, just the tip of a very big iceberg.
There is little room for failure here. We all know that meth especially has the ability to fundamentally change society. We see that we're on that path.
The battle against drugs is now one of the government's highest priorities, boosting police and customs coffers by more than $1 million each, New Zealand sending another $9 million. In a year, there have been 263 arrests, the youngest aged 13, the oldest 67. More than 30 kilos of meth has been seized with a street value of more than 26 million New Zealand dollars, and 28 police officers have been suspended. The walls are closing in, the police minister furious that many of those connected with the trade remain at top levels of society.
Don't think you can sit on some high places and think you're too high for the police to reach. It's just a matter of time. You deal, you pay.
Despite police successes, there's a brutal fight ahead.
We are at a make or break point now. The number of addicts has risen exponentially in Tonga over the past year. The number of dealers has also risen.
We are already right now a failed state, you know, to put it frankly. And so this meth thing will just totally destroy us.
Tofoa, a tiny pocket of the capital Nuku'alofa, is a hot zone of meth houses and dealers.
How many of you, when I asked them, actually involved in this? They say about more than 200 of us.
Like this woman who became a dealer to fuel her habit.
We created around 400, 500, so I can sell them approximately 5 grams a day. I can sell them, but I can smoke 1 gram a day.
Her clients included young teens who in turn started selling the drug or their bodies to buy meth. The impact on families is devastating.
My partner uses drugs every 30 minutes to an hour. He attacks me when he uses drugs. He always has in hand some kind of sharp weapon, a gun, a steel rod.
This mother's home became a major drug distribution centre. She recently took her children and fled. Police ignored photos and information she gave them. Her partner continues big-time dealing.
I never trust the police.
Again, no help. The police is helping my partner.
It's clear war is now being waged. More uncertain is who will win.
And Barbara joins us now. Barb, can Tonga handle this growing crisis on its own?
No, it's too big a mountain for any one resource-strapped country to climb on its own, especially given that there's widespread and high-level involvement in the meth trade there. So, look, the Tongan government has asked the Pacific Forum for help to come up with a drugs policy, and there's a couple of New Zealand police and also Aussie cops on the ground to assist, but it is the Tongan police who are driving this. They're systematic going through department by department, weeding out corruption, including in their own. Customs is on the hit list, as is the prisons, because there's a lot of meth behind bars, believe it or not. Look, it's dire. It is absolutely dire, but there are some real Tongan superheroes in this story, and they don't wear capes, but they are there putting their lives on the line, putting their family security on the line to make a difference in this hideous meth epidemic. You can hear their stories tomorrow here on One News.
Look forward to it. Thanks, Barb.